if the year before that, we knew Lamar Smith was going to be the guy who got reelected and who was going to get appointed to the committee, we probably could have focused our efforts on him right away, but we don't know who the target is until the target is, makes himself known, you know. So not a whole lot was known about him and his district and the things that he was doing until this comes up, because he's a target, he's in the news and those types of things. We really haven't heard too much back from him other than all of the information, you know, like the text information from NORML that is really undeniable, the clinical handbook that we use, was presented to him at his Republican fundraiser. So it was given to him personally by, I think, Aaron Houston, I don't remember who, but I mean, by a reputable activist who actually got his question queued amongst the questions at the fundraiser. So is it a cop-out? I think everything that politicians give us is a cop-out. It's that not specifically answer a question at all. You know, that's what politics is. I think it was more of a lack of not really understanding the true fundamentals of how much this policy, you know, is supported by the general public and how much economic value it would be for them. So, and that's fine because it's easier to counter someone's objectives if we know what their objectives are. If we don't know what their objections are, if we don't know what their objections are, it's a little bit harder to turn them. So, that's fine. So, other than that, constant awareness. We will do this for you guys too. This is something that we don't necessarily do these for every meeting because we don't know who is going to be there. But since we know Appleton is a rather, we're going to have a turnout here for our next meeting, I will custom make flyers specifically for your legislators in your area. It works well with the little rip-offs on the bottom too, so that you can hang these up so people can grab those phone numbers. And I think the phone number really works well, that if we can get those people calling our legislators, it works well. So we'll find out who exactly the legislators are here in the Appleton area. We'll have that prepped for our next meeting so that you guys can have them. As soon as it's ready, we'll put it online to the print your own forms too. I made these specifically for my, this one we made for the people who were on the committee for the medical marijuana bill in the last session, but I specifically have one that, do you support medical marijuana, with my senator and my assembly rep on there. Just there are two names only on there, and that's the one that I use in my community, because I want the people, you know, in my community to know what's going on and for them to interact with their members. So, yes, question.
Can I see the paper?
Sure.
Sorry.
If anybody wants to help, has any skills whatsoever, and wants to make flyers and stuff for us, by all means, you know, take charge of it yourself. Say, hey, Jay, you know, I want to make some flyers. What do I put on the flyers? I'll tell you what to put on there. Feel free to liberty to make them yourself. You know, that's fine, too. Matter of fact, that's what a lot of activists do. It's one thing that we're trying to do is develop a network, some sort of synergy. I think we're going to do it online through a forum-type situation. Front-end forum for activists and general public to see what's going on. Back-end of the forum for board of directors, for moderators, and for people who are brainstorming different events and those types of things. But definitely having some place to go so that you can print your own forms, or some place that you can go online, or someplace that you can physically go to get these pre-printed forms and literature is important. So we're working on an Appleton location. Appleton Imports has volunteered. They're downtown. I don't know their address right offhand, but we're just starting to work in this area. So we'd be more than happy to have several locations being able to carry our stuff. But Appleton Imports has agreed to carry our shirts and our literature and stuff like that. So if you're in the Appleton area and you don't, what's that?
I was saying they're right next to Munchies.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Seriously though, that's
so that, you know, that's going to be key right there. It's just to have a hub for activists to go to get that information. But again, it should be all online. So
we have weekly farmers markets. It's the farmers market.
The problem, a lot of people don't realize, but like the farmers market for downtown here was $600 to get the permit, the diamond there or something like that. So we don't have the money.
Oh, I'm talking about us walking.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Seeing our neighbors
definitely.
And our friends,
yes,
and
yes,
talking,
yes,
to the farmers,
yes,
as they're there.
Yes, yes. Oh, no, definitely. So as far as the, it's always difficult to do those types of things. That's why we want to give the activists and to have the tools to go in the field and do that themselves. You're definitely right. Hit it right on the head. So what's worked well for me is just carrying a sign, you know, like support ending federal marijuana prohibition, sign here, you know, carry that around, people see it, and that way you don't have to bombard everybody, and people will come up to you, and you'll be able to do that. So, if you know a vendor at the farm market that vends regularly, that's fine too, you know, you can certainly ask them. Actually, now that you say that, we have one of our vendors who actually vends for quite a while, so he would serve us, or whatnot.
Yeah, most of the farmers are really particular about what they have to get everything approved prior to.
Right.
It's not like you can just go down there and.
Right.
Drop off a stack of flyers, because they'll get kicked out of the farmer's market then.
Right. See, didn't know that. See, that's another thing, that's one of the things that we like to know. Same thing, we had somebody who said, hey, let's do the parade. We're like, all right, let's do the parade, you know? And then we contacted the parade, and they're like, no, we won't let you in the parade. Or, let's do the health fair. Yeah, all right. Well, the first step is, find out the rules of these places that we want to do, find out if it's feasible for us to be there, and if it is, we'll explore it. If it's not, let's move on to something else, you know? So, but yeah, we're.
Have you looked into Oktoberfest here?
Can't do it.
No?
No. That was actually the event that we used. That was one of them too. So.
How come? Curious as to why.
Yeah. We know. Where's Rich and. What was the reason we couldn't do Oktoberfest?
Yeah.
We looked it up online and they said we couldn't do it. I don't remember. We'd have to look that up. Remember when we looked in Oktoberfest? There was some reason that we can do it. Couldn't do it, so.
Yeah, it was an arbitrary reason.
I know a lot of those kind of events don't want you to get political.
Right. Yeah, actually that's what it was. No political. It was no political. It was only for vendors and people selling stuff. It was no political, no nonprofits, no nothing. It wasn't a community.
And alcohol.
Oh, yeah.
Alcohol.
The one thing that we do want to do, which, when's your Outagamie County Fair?
Next week,
we, meaning our chapter and NORML as a whole, would sponsor a booth. We would probably give you the literature, preprint the stuff, you know, maybe buy you a table and chairs and stuff like that, but that's something that we would like local activists to do. You know, we would probably, as NORML members, we would thank you very much.
I'll just drop that.